I think that when you deal with issues like this, and we all have varying degrees of these feelings, but I think when you have them really acutely, one of the things you're aware of is it's your job to manage your feelings literally moment to moment. I think it's a little bit like having a twisted ankle, where even though I'm sitting here, I am aware that I'm going to have to stand at the end of this interview.
Yes. And I know what it's going to feel like.
Yes. And right around the corner, if I'm not careful, these feelings are there, and they're going to take me someplace. They're going to take me for a ride.
Right.
Someplace I have no control over. And so I think that, you know, you lose control, or you get a little less diligent, and something overtakes you. He writes really beautifully about depression in a lot of his work, and the sort of overpowering nature. You know, you hear this idea of, like, just kind of feel your way out of it. And I think it shows a lack of understanding of how completely immersive that feeling is.
Did he talk about it to Lipsky much?
He did talk about it a bit, and there are some things in the recordings that really moved me. One of them is when he talks about using every mental gymnastics, was the phrase he used, and it really hit me. Using all the mental gymnastics at his disposal just to feel okay. And it's one of the things that's raised in the movie. Is this a facade that David Foster Wallace is putting on for Lipsky's benefit? And I think that there is a facade, but I don't think it's for Lipsky's benefit. I think it's for his own benefit.
Go ahead.
Yeah, well, just to construct a version of yourself where you feel okay moment to moment. A lot of this stuff is sort of fake it till you make it. Like, I'm going to choose to feel okay today.